Okay, I am going to start the spectrogram timeline. And the moment that I do that, you can see it absolutely light up. This is a color one. I'm sorry, Gretchen. This isn't a black and white one.
I know I'm going to have to get used to it.
I'm sure you'll cope. It is a lot of fun. Those brighter red bits mean that something is louder or there's more acoustic intensity there. And you can see already that there are gaps and they are not the gaps between words.
And there are potentially gaps between speakers, which are probably really easy to see. When I see this going live compared to Prot, which is so like you record a sound and then you get the spectrum of that sound, I just see this moving so fast.
Indeed.
But I guess this is how fast we're talking. Like it's moving at the rate of 1 second per second. So there we are. So it's tricky right now because the sound is doing a whole bunch of stuff because we're producing full sentences. So let's do some tests with simpler sounds.
Let's start with fricatives because they have that really distinct noisy pattern that is a bit like static on television. So let's try make some basic fricative sounds.
Okay.
I hope you didn't tune in then. It would have sounded like we've gone off air.
Yeah. I think the fun thing is you can see like the s is really higher pitched and the sh is a little bit lower, but also a little bit louder, which is maybe why the shing sound lets you, you know, get someone's attention to shush them. And the f is a really kind of quieter and more dispersed it's really hard to go smoothly between them from one to the next.
So even though they look like static, they're all their own special flavor of static that has more information we can learn about them.
Yeah, absolutely. Okay, let's look at vowels. So we can move between vowels more easily maybe than between the fricatives.
I can see those intensity bands really changing between the different vowels, which is how your brain is beginning to process the difference between something like ah and something like e.
And I think you can see the sort of pitch going on more easily. Like if I go ah, you can see that pitch go up and down. Ah, like that's just the same vowel, but the pitch changing. Whereas they're going back and forth between you can see those bands kind of go in and out of existence.
And that's how acoustic phonetics can help us study things like intonation or languages that have tone differences between words.
Or, yeah, things like pitch and stress, because you can often the most stressed syllable of a word or of a phrase is going to show up really bright on a spectrogram.
I'll try alternating vowels and fricatives so you can really see the difference between the types of visual information they're giving us.
Yes.
So, sa, si, su, sa, si, su.
Sa, si, su, sa, si, su, sa, si, su, sa, si, su. You can also see what laughter looks like, which I think is really great. It's got that sort of irregular ha shape.
Very distinct there.
The pauses in the middle of laughter is what brings us to stops, which give us that bit of silence in between things. So let's leave a second of silence just to see what silence actually looks like on the spectrogram.
Because stops are made of nothing, the easiest way to see them is to put them in between some vowels. We'll put them in a little vowel sandwich so that we can see them nice and clearly.
A little vowel carrier knapsack.
A-pa, 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 a-ta, a-ta, a-ka.
A-ba, a-ka, 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 ba, 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 ba.
So many little moments of nothing that you can see in the spectrogram, and you begin to read those absences as stops once you start paying attention to what's happening with the spectrogram.
Yeah, and like the difference between silence and a stop consonant is just like what happens to the vowel when you come out of it.
So that's three basic elements of reading a spectrogram with your eyeballs.